Hi, I'm Tim from Scoop, and today we're going to be taking a look at some of MikroTik 60GHz wireless devices and which would best be suited for different installations. Anyone who has installed outdoor wireless links has undoubtedly come across the headache of radio interference and throughput limitations. In recent years, a few vendors have released 60GHz solutions to better facilitate the scalability of outdoor wireless deployments. 60GHz is certainly very desirable to unlicensed operators, as it provides extremely high performance when compared to 5 and 2.4 GHz. This is attributed to the wider channels, a much cleaner frequency spectrum that is available on the band. The downside is, you can only achieve great performance on relatively short distance in good weather. Let me explain. First of all, high frequencies attenuate quicker than lower frequencies, which naturally means 5 GHz would suffer less from path loss than 60 GHz. In addition, 60 GHz can experience up to 98% of its RF energy being absorbed by oxygen molecules. This makes it extremely vulnerable to wet weather condition. Having said this, there are benefits. When using the 60 GHz band, it's far more difficult to hear unwanted signals from competitive devices, resulting in virtually no interference. It also has a smaller Fresnel zone, and therefore it's easier to establish clear line of sight due to its short wave characteristics. Ultimately, the biggest advantage offered by 60 GHz is the huge performance boost when comparing it to traditional unlicensed bands, with several of these products capable of gigabit speeds. Unlike most vendors, MikroTik offers a number of different devices which allow you to utilize 60GHz in point-to-point and point-to-multipoint scenarios. All of the MikroTik 60GHz options are fully integrated devices, meaning they feature both the radio and the antenna in one unit. All of the 60GHz units use beamforming technology, which focuses wireless signals to a specific device instead of the more traditional signal spread technique. MikroTik have designed several 60GHz series devices, which include LHG, WAP, Cube, and NRAY ranges of products. The LHG, Cube, and NRAY product also come in a pre-configured kit to allow installers a true plug-and-play installation. Contrary to the perception that MikroTik requires advanced networking skills to configure, they have made these kits super simple to allow less experienced users access to the benefits of 60GHz. These devices can also be individually configured and fine-tuned in RootOS. Even if you're a new user, MikroTik offers an easy, quick setup configuration via all of their user interface platforms. It's also worth mentioning that when configuring point-to-point links in MikroTik, only a Level 3 router license is required in order to achieve a wireless bridge. Let's take a look at which MikroTik 60GHz products are the best choice for you, starting from the shortest to the longest achievable range. The WAP range offers the shortest distance in both point-to-point and point-to-multipoint configurations. Cube should generally be used for intermediate distances, while NRAY and LHGs provide the longest distance. You'll notice that all devices are compatible with each other, but this affects overall range depending on devices used. When taking a closer look, each series has at least one feature that stands out from the rest. The Cube 60AC is a small form factor with 5GHz AC failover to keep your link up at all times. This is awesome for locations with rainy conditions. The LHG has the largest antenna and is suitable for the longer distances. There are a few different mounts available for the LHG to allow for precision alignment or just a more sturdy option. Though these mounts are sold separately, we suggest using these in all long distance links in order to assist with more accurate alignment. The NRAY unit is built for more extreme environments such as mountaintops where snow and ice may affect signal when settled on parts of the antenna. The radome design assists by preventing buildup on the feeder reflector. If configuring your link to be point to multipoint, you need to make use of one of the WAPs in access point mode. This is the only option as it offers a wide enough beam width and a level 4 MikroTik license to enable AP mode. The WAP 60GAP has a 60 degree beam width, while the WAP 60GAP 3 has 180 degree beam width for this really wide angle links. No matter which WAP you use, you can connect up to 8 wireless clients per AP. MikroTik is one of the very few vendors which currently offers 60GHz point-to-multipoint, so this is a huge advantage for those looking to create high-capacity micropops and easily contend with higher speeds. When it comes to CPE choice, we recommend keeping your distances as short as possible to compensate for rain fade, or use high-gain antenna devices like the LHG to ensure signal levels can be adjusted for optimum performance. 60GHz is definitely becoming more common in the world of wireless, and MikroTik have clearly heeded the call to offer customers a multitude of solutions to get the job done. We hope this video is helpful and provided you with some insight into what MikroTik has to offer in terms of their 60GHz products. For more information and links to the products on our website, please see the description below. Also, let us know what you think in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like and subscribe to our channel for more content. Thanks for watching. I'm Tim from Scoop.